Good afternoon. I will call the order of the meeting of the Greenwood Stormwater Board. It's Wednesday, July 13th at 4 o'clock. Can I have roll call, please?
Emmett Payne?
Here.
Tim McLaughlin?
Here.
Orissa?
Here.
All right. Is there a motion for the approval of our minutes from the last meeting of June 8th?
I'll make that motion. Second.
Any discussion about the minutes?
No.
All right. All in favor of approval, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So those being approved. And if nobody has any objections, I think we'll move up the bond issue. Guys, all right? Okay. Let's move that up.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Zach Klutz. I'm the TAP law firm and serving as bond counsel with respect to the stormwater bonds that this board is considering. We kind of have three things to take care of this afternoon. The first two are kind of statutory in nature. At your last meeting on June 8th, you adopted a declaratory resolution declaring a need for certain stormwater improvements. That, by statute, is the first step required before you can incur debt and issue bonds. After you adopted that declaratory resolution, which was 2201, we published notice that there will be a public hearing this afternoon for the public to weigh in on your declaration of need for stormwater improvement projects. So statutorily, we need to kind of just pause for a moment, open the floor up to see if anyone would like to present comments to this body for purposes of this project. So if we could do that now, and then I can move on to the next steps.
All right. Is there anybody in the audience or on Zoom or online that has any comments? All right, hearing none, we'll move forward.
Okay, hearing none, we can close the public hearing. The next step then is, again, by statute, is to adopt a confirmatory resolution. The reason it's a two-step process is you presumably would take in any comment that the public has or suggestions for modifications or any other comment you may have received from the time of the publication or the adoption of the declaratory resolution. So, before you is simply a confirmatory resolution number 2202, confirming in all respects your declaratory resolution and the description of the project. So I guess the next step would be a vote or adoption of confirmatory resolution number 2202. And happy to answer any questions. But again, the content of that resolution is simply confirming the project and the need for the project.
Is there a motion?
I'll make the motion.
Second. All right. Any other discussion regarding the confirmatory? All right. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And that is being adopted.
Great. The third and final step for this afternoon is consideration and a vote upon the actual bond resolution. This is resolution 2203. And this resolution, just to summarize, authorizes the issuance and sale of the City of Greenwood Stormwater District Revenue Bonds of 2022. They would be in the maximum amount of $4 million. I think we're anticipating or targeting a bond amount of $3,895,000. These would authorize a maximum interest rate of 5%. And we don't know what that interest rate will be until we receive the bids from interested lenders. But we would not accept this. This resolution would not authorize you to accept a bond or a bid that had an interest rate in excess of 5%. The term will be not longer than 14 years, so maturity date of October 1, 2036 or earlier. And in terms of next steps, we currently have these bonds closing September 13th, 2022. So between now and September 13th, 2022, we would obtain Common Council's approval. We also have to obtain their approval for these bonds. That's scheduled to occur August 1st. August 2nd is on the timeline. We would release the term sheets to banks to receive bids on the bonds. And we have currently scheduled the bids due August 23rd. And then again, closing and funding on these bonds September 13th. I'm here to answer any questions you have on the bond resolution, and to the extent there's any questions that are financial in nature, Jennifer Hudson of London Woody is also participating via Zoom, she'd be happy to answer any questions that are financial in nature.
Any questions?
So I would just entertain a motion and approval of resolution 2203, the bond resolution.
All right. Is there a motion?
I'll make that. I'll second the motion.
All right. Any other discussion on this issue?
No.
All right. All in favor, say aye.
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 Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right. Back up to our... Yeah, the old business.
Yeah. Okay. For the record, Director Stormwater Management, Chris Jones, would like to revisit our fence. Fence contract and the needs of the fence across the front of the nature center. Board recalls we received a quote for $34,290. And the board asked that we try to secure some more estimates. So we did, and I would like, I'm honored to say that we found a comparable fence that's going to match everything else that we've done around DPW at the amphitheater. So it is from Secure Links Fence Company to install 188 feet of tall industrial grade asphalt aluminum fence with a 22-foot sliding gate for a total of $16,810. So if you recall that it's about half what our last estimate was. So I recommend a motion to accept the estimate from Secure Links Fence Company for the construction of the fence, terms and conditions to be outlined by the legal department, and authorize the stormwater superintendent to sign the board's behalf.
I think you may not accept the estimate, you approve a contract.
Approve the contract.
All right. Is there a motion?
I'll make that motion.
I'll second the motion.
All right. Any questions about this?
I'm curious. Where is the fence coming from?
Where are they from? They're from Whiteland.
Great. Thank you. Good job.
300 yes. Whiteland.
Good job, Chris.
All right.
Yep.
Anything else? All right. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
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 Okay. Next item on the agenda. Okay. So if the board recalls, the last meeting, we talked about the floor covering for the Nature Center, and I want to be transparent. We'll stay with the lake that we did have, broadcast lake, the frazzled floor. Considering that we saved so much with the fence, we thought we'd like to revisit by doing the terrazzo floor in our garage classroom, and then the other classroom, we go with this metallic water pipe appearance. So what that would do would increase the cost of the project from $27,938 to $31,553, or an increase of $3,650. So I would recommend the motion that we make an addendum to current agreement with Monster Coat to do terrazzo lake in the garage section of the Nature Center, and the metallic epoxy up front to increase this contract by $3,650 for a total of $31,553. Terms of this should be outlined by the Lake Department, and authorize the stormwater superintendent to sign the board's behalf.
All right. Is there a motion?
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Is there any comments about this? All right. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
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 business. New business, we're going to purchase a new vacuum street sweeper and I'll introduce it on pay to the police department.
Yeah. There's that thing to, been looking to upgrade or replace the current vacuum street sweeper. And we have the opportunity to do that and actually save some money. So I'm here requesting approval to purchase a 2022 Busher Model B65T vacuum street sweeper that's mounted on a 2022 Kenworth K370 chassis. The actual purchase amount would be for $336,000, and that would be using a source oil contract. And at the same time, I'd also request if this was approved, the approval to trade in the 2016 Elgin Whirlwind vacuum street sweeper mounted on a Freightliner chassis VIN-NUGX4221 for a trade-in value of $41,000, which would bring the actual purchase price to $295,000. And that will be paid for using the city's Huntington lease with the first payment due in January, I believe. And by purchasing now compared to ordering here in a few months, the unit they have, there's an expected savings for the increase. We'll say approximately $65,000 for the exact same unit. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
So this is a, you said it was a
B65? B65T.
Okay.
A Busher B65T.
All right, so we need to craft a motion.
Yes, I sent you a memorandum with the proposed motion for the special purchase because you are doing this because you have the opportunity for special savings. It is a special savings sort of purchase method, and we have to particularly find that, and we have to make that determination, and we have to make basically a memorandum because we have to keep that in a separate file for the board of accounts when they audit us. So I did have proposed motion for you.
Okay.
I recommend that you determine that purchasing the street sweeper as described and presented by the fleet maintenance superintendent through the Sourcewell Purchasing Cooperative provides the opportunity for substantial savings in accordance with Indiana Code Section 522.10.5 to authorize the lease purchase of the street sweeper in an amount not to exceed $295,000 from Brown Equipment Company through the city's master lease agreement with Huntington Public Capital Corporation, and to authorize the mayor and the police maintenance superintendent to sign any and all documents to effectuate purpose purchase with final terms and conditions for the purchase to be determined by the legal department. I would add also that you specifically authorized trading in the current street sweeper, which I believe was that Elgin on the Freightliner M2 model Whirlwind 2016. Street sweeper.
Is there a motion?
Make a motion.
Okay.
Second.
Any other discussion?
No, sir.
All right. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
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 Thank you. Thank you, Todd.
All right, anything from the audience? Hearing none, we'll move on to reports. Council?
Sure.
Okay, so the engineer, I do not see anybody. Mr. Controller, anything?
Nothing else.
Okay. All right, Chris, back to you.
All right, I do not have any O&M manuals for you. We have a few reports. So we increased the amount of street sweeping debris, 3 tons to 47.23 tons. That's awesome. 1,900 cubes of form, 12.56 tons of debris, miscellaneous jetting, a lot of hydro excavating, working with the street department, replacing some catch basins and items like that. We're down in precipitation from last year, so we've got 1.83 inches for this month so far, 74.49 average temperature, 214 work orders initiated, 219 completed, 27 requests initiated, 25 completed, 2,764 locates, 35 ESC permits, 165 ESC inspections, 43 hotspots cleared, and 39 right-of-way closed. So, as you know, the locators have become locators and right-of-way inspectors. So we're still working on our reports to see how many inspections we do and right-of-ways are full. So right now, we're just going to give you a close portion. Education outreach, Mitch, we've been working with Hoosier River Wash and the summer campers. We're at the amphitheater. Once we get the HNL, hopefully we'll be done. That's all I have.
Anything from the mayor's office? Commissioners, anything you want to address?
No, sir.
All right. We've gone to approval of claim dockets. So that's for a motion.
I'll move we accept as presented.
I'll second that.
All in favor of approval, say aye.
Aye.
So it's being approved. All right. So anything else needs to come before the board today? Hearing none, we will be adjourned at 4:16.